Welcome to Tales from SYL Ranch, where everyone is entitled to my opinion, and I'm Bill Stone. Now, this is part one of a four-part series that evaluates abortion in the context of the zero aggression principle, which, as you can see scrolling past in my lower third right now, no human being has the right, under any circumstances, to initiate force against another human being, nor to threaten or delegate its initiation. As I mentioned in the introduction yesterday, since a fetus is a potential human being, at what point does it actually qualify as a human being? And thus, when is it a violation of the zero aggression principle to initiate force against it by aborting it? In this part, I will discuss the zero aggression principle and how and when it generally applies. Then in part two, I'm going to get into the concept of human intelligence, and I'm going to tackle the subject of sentience, what it is, how we can see it in human beings and others, and how it is a precursor to sapience in human beings. Then in part three, I'm going to discuss sapience, which is different from sentience as it occurs only in human beings and not in any other animal on Earth. And then in part four, I'm going to finally come to a conclusion about what the zero aggression, how the zero aggression principle applies to abortion. Now, I've said occasionally in other videos that what sets zero aggression principle style libertarians like myself apart from everyone else is the topic for a completely different video. This is that video. We have to start out with basic premises. We have to understand where I come from on this, what the zero aggression principle is and what it means, and some test cases and things like that. We have to start out with that when talking about abortion in this context, because otherwise you won't understand what I'm saying. So we have to start from the basics. The zero aggression principle, which again states no human being has the right under any circumstances to initiate force against another human being, nor to threaten or delegate its initiation. Now, one thing you have to note is the zero aggression principle does not define force as unethical. It defines the initiation of force unethical. It is, for example, unethical for a mugger to pull a gun on someone and force them to give up their money. However, it is completely ethical for a victim to draw a gun and kill the mugger. That is responding to initiated force. Now, it's also unethical for a mugger to even threaten a victim in any way with any weapon or just with their fists. However, it is still completely ethical for the victim to draw their gun and shoot the mugger. Initiated force may be stopped by any means necessary, even if it turns out, and sometimes especially if it turns out, that the victim was better armed than the mugger. Now, the zero aggression principle applies at all levels and not just to the personal level. It states that you cannot delegate initiated force, and this is what really sets zero aggression principle style libertarians, as myself, and distinguishes us from the Libertarian Party, for say, in the United States, which doesn't actually represent our views. And this is because, in addition to applying to human beings, the zero aggression principle also applies to government, because government initiates force. Now, a good example of this, you know, we all like to talk about this one because it's very easy to talk about. Taxes. We always say as libertarians, taxation is theft. And I will explain to you right now why that is. Because government obtains tax money through the initiation of force. Nobody pays taxes willingly, because if we did, we probably wouldn't pay them at all. Now, if you follow this chain, if you fail to pay your taxes, then a bunch of guys in suits are going to demand that you pay. If you continue to not pay your taxes, then people with guns will demand that you pay. And if you continue to not pay your taxes, they will throw you in jail. And if you resist these men with guns, they will kill you. Just compare that to a mafia running a shakedown racket. It's exactly the same, except that government is doing it. We don't make exceptions for that. This is why government must always use the threat of death whenever it passes any law of any kind, no matter how innocuous may seem. Ultimately, if you don't go along with it, they will kill you. The ultimate threat behind any government action is death. And zero aggression principle styles like libertarians like myself do not make exceptions for government. Government always initiates force. Therefore, government as a concept is itself unethical. And this is why, as a zero aggression principle libertarian, I see no reason for government to be involved in abortion or anything else. You know, at the very least, what you can say is, if you beg government to make decision for someone else, you're automatically begging them to make the decision for you. And it will backfire on you. I mean, maybe not today, maybe not tomorrow, but soon and for the rest of your life. Note also that the zero aggression principle only applies to human beings, because only human beings can achieve sapience. And again, that's part three of this series. The zero aggression principle cannot apply to animals such as dogs, cats, pets, or livestock. That's because these animals are non-sapient. They cannot even comprehend the concept of initiated force. So it doesn't even apply to them. And I'll talk more about that when we get to some of it. But if you want to really get a simple thing of what, you know, the zero aggression principle really means, it means this: don't start nothing, won't be nothing. And so that's all I've got to say about that for today. Tune in tomorrow for part two of this series, where I will discuss and define sentience. We get into the thorny subject of human intelligence that, along with the zero aggression principle, is key to discovering whether an abortion is ethical or not. So if you like what I'm doing, please do like this video, subscribe to my channel, hit the notification bell, share me on social media, and tell all of your friends, family, neighbors, pets, and livestock to do the same. I'd really love if we kept the conversation going in my comments box, and I would certainly appreciate your support, either via my PayPal tip jar, my Subscribestar, or a place on my website where you can support me further, and there are links to all of them in my description box below. So, thanks for watching Tales from SYL Ranch, and remember, for a breath of fresh air, watch Tales from SYL Ranch, where everyone is entitled to my opinion. And I'm Bill Stone.
Ultimate power in this world has always been one simple thing: the control and manipulation of minds.